But on a day I was walking slowly in Miami Beach, watching the girls with the tango that was trotting down the street. One ugly looking woman tapped me in the back. She had an automatic and riding in a bike. She said, turn around slowly, show me your green card. I said, I don't have it, just came from New Orleans. I'm just a guitar player from a Bourbon Street. She said without a smile, you tell that to the judge. She took me right away to the 11th court. The judge says, Mary Lou, what's wrong with you? This man is the wolfman, come from the bayou. He don't need no green card. And besides, you're not an immigration officer, Mary Lou. What's wrong with you? Mary Lou, what's wrong with you? Mary, Mary Lou, I think I'm falling in love with you. She looks so sexy, man, on that little bicycle, riding around with those little pipe pants and that blouse, man. And she had a body unbelievable. Never seen a cop like that in the life. Mary Lou, I'm gonna take you to Baton Rouge. Mary Lou, I'm falling in love with you. I never had no police woman. Yeah. She looks so hot. And she was wearing some real tight hot pants. She wanted to make my green card, yeah. I say, I don't even have a driver's license. You know, in the bayou, we only ride boats. You know, we don't even go to the supermarket. We go and fish what we need and cut whatever we need. Right? Occasionally I get an alligator, sometimes I get a speckled trout, turtle soup, crawfish all the time, moonshine, redfish, and we get some collard greens, and occasionally a little okra, baby, blue crab, well, from the bayou, baby, you gotta enjoy that, Mary Lou. Mary Lou, falling in love with you. Falling in love with you. She was wearing shorts that were real high. Yeah. Nice little blouse. And she was riding in a real nice bike. Mary Lou, baby, I hope you like the boogie. Boogie. Miami Beach. Boogie. With a flavor of New Orleans. Yeah. We'll put a little spice in it. Yeah, the judge was cool. Yeah, the judge had a Stratocaster sitting there. He confiscated from somebody. He said, hey, whoa, man, why don't you play that? And he had a set of drums. And then the bailiff, he had a bass. But we all started jamming. Mary Lou started dancing. Yeah. We had a couple of mojitos. And I fixed him a hurricane. Mary Lou, fall in love with you. So the judge says, you release, wolf man. put Mary Lou to custody you, so you don't get no bother anymore. Yeah, you don't have to have no green card. Just play guitar. Yeah, that's enough for me. New Orleans boogie in Miami Beach.
Aujourd'hui, je veux dire merci beaucoup à tous les Français et les gens de Toulouse et les maires de Toulouse. Bueno, me equivoqué de lenguaje. Lo que quería decir es dar las gracias a la gente de Toulouse. Es una cosa de verdad increíble porque Toulouse es lo máximo.
Sinfonía del espacio en do menor. Estamos volando en una nave invisible por todo el universo, la nave de la música. Pueden oír las guitarras, la percusión, los saxofones, pueden oír el piano increíble, pero estamos siempre dentro de la Vía Láctea. Disfruten el viaje, es largo y corto a la vez. Sinfonía del espacio. Atlantic coast of Nicaragua. I want to go back to Africa. learn the real beats of the heart of the jungle. From the Momotombo to the Kilimanjaro, from blue fields to the Congo. Africa to learn the beats of the jungle. Save the rhinoceros from the poachers.
Wow.
yo sé que yo soy músico, pero desde que yo era niño, a mí me ha gustado mucho la literatura. Yo siempre escribía poesía, cuentos. No solo tengo más de 500 poesías. No las puedo sacar todas porque si yo saco las poesías que yo he hecho, me mandan a fusilar. Bueno, pero este libro lo comencé a escribir hace como 8 años en Nicaragua, en la playa, en San Juan del Sur. Y yo siempre he tenido la idea de un superhéroe latinoamericano. ¿Por qué? Porque aquí todos los superhéroes, Batman, Superman, Aquaman, toda esa gente son americanos. Son superhéroes hechos para los cartoons americanos, para los muñequitos. Y yo quería un superhéroe latinoamericano, que el único que existía en ese momento era Chespirito, que era en realidad pues un superhéroe como de mentirita, como de una burla, y era una cosa muy simpática, pero era cómico. Yo quería un superhéroe de verdad latinoamericano. ¿Y quién es el personaje que escogí? El torero. ¿Por qué? Porque un torero es algo que solo existe en España, México, Colombia, el Ecuador y países que tienen el habla y el alma hispana. Entonces yo hice mi super torero, que es un superhéroe latinoamericano, el primero, y escribí mi novela. Me tardó 7 años, pero ya la he presentado en Madrid. En España me la presentó Jaime Hostos, que es uno de los más grandes toreros de la historia española. Bueno, importante recalcar que este próximo domingo, el día 24 a las 10 de la mañana, este libro será presentado en Miami, en el Miami Book Fair, en el Wolfson Center, en el centro de Miami. Y eso, vamos a estar ahí en un stand desde las 10 de la mañana hasta las 7 de la noche dedicando libros, y vamos a tener algunos libros en existencia. Claro, este libro sale en Amazon. Ustedes se meten en Amazon, la historia, la increíble historia del super torero Alfonso Lobo, y sale en Amazon. Pues sale en Barnes & Noble, sale en Walmart, hasta en Walmart me están vendiendo. El otro día me metí al internet y dije, Alfonso Lobo, Walmart. O sea que debo estar de moda porque el libro ya está de venta en Walmart.
Black Bull in the Gulf of Mexico. I went to New Orleans this morning, getting hungry, baby, driving from Baton Rouge. And I went right to the French Quarter, wanted to have some seafood. Then I want to see my friend Steve. He has a restaurant there. Great seafood. Yeah. And I say, hey, Steve, I want to have some oysters. Give me a dozen. In New Orleans, they say 13 because they give you a lagniappe. Yeah. And then I want to have a few barbecued shrimp. And in the meantime, give me a little gumbo. Yeah, with plenty of crab meat. Grab me a couple crawfish he had sitting in the table. Yeah, I love that New Orleans seafood. I put the crawfish in my mouth, and they taste like gasoline. Wow. I grabbed me an oyster, really nice and tender, and I put it in my mouth, and it tastes like diesel. I think something's wrong with my taste buds. So I say, hey, Steve, give me one of them shrimps. So he gave me a couple of shrimp, barbecue shrimp, really nice. And it tastes like kerosene. Man, something's wrong. So I say, hey, Steve, let me have one of them beers. One of them beers, I want to wash my taste buds. Because, you know, everything tastes like diesel or gasoline. What? Yeah. So he picked up his phone and called his friend HL in Mississippi and said, anything wrong with the product you're sending me? And he said, yeah, man, we had a big problem here in the Gulf. Black hole in the Gulf of Mexico.
Bueno, este es el resultado de todo el trabajo que estuvimos haciendo. Lo que quiero explicarles es que yo estoy promoviendo la comida sana, los mariscos, lo que aquí llaman en los Estados Unidos el seafood, porque mi empresa es una compañía de mariscos, se llama Wildland Farm Seafood, y nosotros promovemos los productos de Florida, por ejemplo la langosta, el ceviche hecho de la corvina que traigo de Surinam, que es de primera, los camarones, esos los traje del Ecuador, también me los mandan de México, son camarones salvajes, se llaman langostinos, y esto es una comida muy sana con bajos carbohidratos y que les va a dar mucho gusto y van a quedar súper bien. Yo no soy un gran chef, pero sí sé cocinar los productos que yo importo y que yo vendo. Así que los convido y vamos a dar en cada programa una receta o dos, dependiendo de qué es lo que esté en temporada. El próximo programa vamos a hacer los Stone Crab de Florida. Es lo máximo. The Gulf of Mexico, the whales, the dolphins, the sea turtles, black hole, and the Gulf of Mexico, pouring oil from the bottom of the sea. All my friends fishermen, they can't go out to work because everything's like diesel gasoline, baby. Black hole. In the Gulf of Mexico, in Mississippi, Pascagoula, Bay St. Louis, New Orleans, Houma, Louisiana, Grand Isle, all the way to Texas. Black hole. In the Gulf of Mexico.
Miami de noche, lo máximo.